Our next speaker is Theodoros Baris. Theodoros Baris' education background is focused on primary education, specializing in multicultural education and social division, while his master was in education policies and social division. To this day, he has served as a teacher, principal of education units, and school counselor on primary education. He has published a series of scientific articles and has participated in various transnational and international scientific fora. As an author, he was also part of authoring themes for the development of education material for primary schools. His professional administrative experience further includes his involvement in positions of responsibility in regional authorities, private and public entities. Today, he is here at the head of scientific and pedagogical guidance of primary education of the Regional Directorate of Primary and Secondary Education of Western Greece to talk to us about integrating and including foreign students in schools.
First of all, I would like to thank Enterprise for this invitation. And I'm very pleasure to be here with a teacher, among teachers from 15 countries. My name is Theodoros Baris. I'm head of scientific and pedagogical guidance for primary education of the Regional Directorate of Primary and Secondary Education in Western Greece. And I have everything problem to talk after Mrs. Spinthouraki, because is very clear and know this field very well. And I will try to be useful for you. So I am from this man who sometimes my voice is louder or slower. Immigration is deeply rooted in European history with a vast and multilateral impact on the hosting countries affecting the economy. There are economic transition influenced by immigration. The civitas, the social body of the citizen, has an impact on the cultural context in European societies in various ways. At polity, immigration clearly has an impact on the political discourse in European societies. This is European statistics where we can see Greece. For this year, 862,000 people from other countries is illegal in Greece. Eurostat statistics allowed no space for questioning the urgency to take up action in the last decades, although statistics, especially on irregular migrants, continue to be incomplete. Greece has a long history of migration. During the decades 1940s to 1970s, the Greek emigrate in search of better living and working conditions. From the early 1970s, Greece becomes the host of a large number of economic, mainly immigrants and repatriated Greeks. Lately, due to recession, things seem to change and mobility from Greece increases once again. Immigration is one of the key elements of history. Diversity. We are all aware of the fact that our cultural environment, on the other hand, is constantly and rapidly changing, becoming more and more diversified. Furthermore, diversity has become an integral condition of human society as a result of increased mobility among countries. Cross-border migration globalization and the advance of communication media. Consequently, more and more individuals are involved in multicultural normality, trying to manage our affiliation. Cultural diversity and the cultural dialogue, on the other hand, constitutes a social, political, and economic entity that needs to be expressed, and its potential should be exploited if it is to bear full fruit. Enabling integration in our societies should be a matter of high priority as the result of an intercultural dialogue, an open and respectful exchange of views between individuals and groups belonging to different cultures that leads to deeper understanding of the other's global perception. From Council of Europe, a white paper on intercultural dialogue. Such a dialogue strengthens constructively the democratic conversation as an antidote to any bigotry and violence. It aims to togetherness in a peaceful and meaningful way, leading to a sense of community, interfaith, and belonging. Sharing perspectives, identifying similarities and differences, democratically managing disputes, bringing the divide between opponents' views, and promoting social cohesion are the objectives of the intercultural dialogue. Education, as all we know, is a key tool for the integration and the intercultural dialogue. Some of the basic pillars for integrating people from other countries should be access to education, social and health services. In order to achieve such goals, a set of strategies should be introduced by the host societies, recording the current situation about the residential, occupational, educational and healthcare conditions of the immigrants, and implementing a set of measures taking under consideration their needs and cultural background. One of the key tools for facilitating the dialogue between people from different countries and their culture is education, where a new status is rising as well. All these people are asked to sit down together and to interchange their unique values. All children and adults have the right to evolve and to develop in a context where there is equity and respect for diversity. Children, parents and educators have the right to good quality in early childhood education services, free from any form of overt and covered individual and structural discriminations due to their race, color, sex, language, religion, political or other opinion, national, ethnic or social origin, property, disability, birth or other status. Intercultural education policy in Greece aimed at the equal integration of all the pupils in the educational system through the implementation of supporting learning action for the improvement of learner performance, using specific action targeting, the implementation of reception classes for immigrant public pupils and supporting learning classes in the context of a Zoom education priority. There is a drawback. The school curricula, as you know, are structured to meet primarily the learning needs and styles of the Greek learners. Taking into the right to education, foreign students can enroll in Greek schools at any moment throughout the year, providing a number of official translating documents. Underage children of third country nationals can also enroll even if their permanent residence is pending. School enrollment is also allowed to refugees, individuals under the protection of the United Nations High Commissioners for Refugees, people from countries that are facing political or other turmoil, individuals who have applied for political asylum. Primary education in Greece, education, educators in early childhood education and in primary education have to comply with curricula based mainly on the needs of the Greek learners and try to reach them with a number of innovative and good practices in order to facilitate equity and inclusion in schools. Primary schools become a field of reception of young students as well. Newcomers from foreign countries enter a new environment full of new stimuli and have to deal with a mosaic of different attitudes and educational needs. One of the key tools to help foreign students cope with language and make effort to soothe the core social conditions they often deal with are the reception classes and intensive tutorial classes. The reception classes refer to young learners with little or no knowledge of Greek languages. They aim to at providing adequate linguistic and further learning support, as well as facilitating the integration of culturally diverse students. We have the two types of reception class, reception class 1 and reception class 2. Students attend the reception class 1 for one school year, whereas those who attend the reception class 2 for 2 years. The intensive tutorial lasts for the whole school years. These classes are parallel to regular classes and offer ample linguistic support to enhance inclusion in regular classes. Reception classes require 9 to 17 students in order to function. Students who attend reception class 1 follow an intensive program for learning Greek so that they can be fully integrated in the regular classes in which they are enrolled. The schedule of reception class 2 is inspired by the idea that students should attend more school hours in regular class in order for them to be fully integrated into it as soon as possible. In intensive tutorial courses, a minimum number of 3 students and maximum number 8 students can participate, and an additional teaching support is provided after the daily schedule for all school classes. The timetable of intensive tutorial courses consists of 10 hours per week, and the subjects staff are modern Greek languages and any other courses proposed by the teacher association. There is also the possibility for students to study and prepare for the next day lessons. The linguistic support of students is performed with regular classes with supportive teaching. Students attending reception class 1 follow intensive Greek languages courses, while at the regular classes they study physical education, visual arts, music education, and foreign languages. Those who attend reception class 2 attend mixed languages and other courses, have flexible learning content and teaching times, and receive both linguistic and further learning support. The so-called zones of education priority cover an increased number of classes for this year. There are 21 reception classes 1 and 19 reception classes 2, functioning within the three prefectures of our regional directorate for the year, this year, 2014-2015. Electrocarmania, 10 and 7 classes, Achaia and Ilia. Supervision and pedagogical guidance. This effort is pedagogically guided and supervised under the direction outlined by the Greek Ministry of Education. The school advisor provides pedagogical counseling to teachers, helping the design of the course of studies and organize training activities. School principal ensures the smooth operation of of the courses, submits annual report to school advisor, and teaching staff keep record for student achievement, submit a report of its semester, and attend training sessions. Projects at the additive initiative at school by default engage school students in informal learning, promote human rights education and democracy, help achieve cultural competence, cultivate living values, promote everyday morality, and raise interest in social issues. In the past 4 years, 2 programs referring to intercultural education took place in our schools, 2 universities were possible and cooperating with school bearing specific goals. The first one comes from the National and Capodistrian University of Athens under the title The Education of Roma Students. This program aims at support Roma students, school attendance in early primary education. The harmonious integration inclusion of students of Roma origins to the Greek educational system and against social exclusion. Assurance of acceptance by the school staff, parents and the community around school. Providing adequate knowledge and material to teachers, family support, and sensitization and, of administrative and educational mechanism and the local community. The program from University of Athens, Capodistrian. And another program, second, was carried out by the Aristotle University of Thessaloniki under the title Foreign and Returning Students Education, Diabolis. The aims of this program, it involved the following action: support of reception class operation, development of Greek language competence of foreign students, teacher training, interventions, school connection to society, school networks, further intercultural education activities, and project evaluation. And some recommendations, a contemporary school should fulfill some social objectives as well. It should identify the diverse field school context, set goals, ask how to nest foreign students equally and comfort them. It should welcome the families and encourage parents to participate in parent-teacher associations. It should strengthen the bonds between the local society and the immigrant families. Thanks for your attention and welcome to this.